Arab Israeli voters are getting a lot of attention from Israel's right wing as the country's general election draws closer. They make up more than 20% of the population and could be the kingmakers in any coalition government. This comes as Israel announced a $45 million push to quell violence in Arab Israeli towns. Critics there call it a band-aid, not a solution, since many in the towns are just as fearful of the police as they are of the criminals roaming the streets. Sam Kiley went to one of these towns where the call to end violence is growing louder.
Newly qualified nurse Ahmed Hijazi got to wear his uniform for just a day before he was killed in crossfire between Israeli police and Israeli Arab suspects. Another victim of growing underworld violence that's hitting Arab-Israeli towns.
He wore the white nurse uniform only for one day. We didn't get the chance to celebrate. They snuffed out the light in my heart.
The number of Arabs murdered in Israel went up by more than a quarter last year, according to the Arab Center for Safe Society. Ahmed died February the 1st in Tamra. In the previous month, there had been 28 shootings and 18 arson attacks in this Israeli city that's being stifled by organized crime, according to police figures. In nearby Umm al-Fahm, 3 weeks earlier, this former mayor, Dr. Suleiman Akhbaria, was shot several times in his car by masked gunmen. He survived and remains in hospital. Locals often believe that the police turn a blind eye to organized criminals.
Anyone in Umm al-Fahm can tell you the names of people who have guns. We have seven families who are gangsters here. And the police and everyone knows they are gangsters. And the police are doing nothing.
Distrust of the police is deep in this town. It goes back 21 years when 13 Israeli Arabs were killed by Israeli police during protests in support of the Palestinian uprising in the nearby West Bank. Israel's parliament estimates that there are 400,000 illegal weapons in Israel, mostly stolen from the army and police, and mostly in the hands of Israeli Arabs. The innocent here pray for an end to the mayhem guns bring. And they march every week to demand better security. Distrust of the police is reinforced when, unprovoked by any crowd violence, the police react like this.
The Israeli police have opened fire with stun grenades and with the foul-smelling, what is known as skunk gun.
Still, some Israeli Arabs blame their own people for the violence which has engulfed them.
My cousin has been shot like 1 month ago because he was in a place, in a store, that some guys started to shoot at that store and my cousin was there. So he was shot in his foot. I can't blame the police for what's going in our society, but I blame the police for the way he treats us and he treats the Jews.
Israel's Arab cities only got permanent police stations in 2017. Arabs make up 21% of Israel's population. Although they often complain of being seen as second-class citizens in the Jewish state, Arab political parties are capable of winning 10 to 15 seats in elections to the 120-seat Knesset. They're still largely shunned by Jewish parties, but could one day be kingmakers in coalitions, especially for the Israeli left. So violence in Arab towns is slowly becoming a mainstream Israeli issue. This Israeli police general, a Muslim Arab, says the police actions during the protest filmed by CNN are already under investigation. Distrust, he agrees, does run very deep.
For decades, the police were not in the villages. For decades, we were not there. It turns out the formula is obvious. Either police in the Arab street or crime in the Arab street. In the past, there were no police. There were criminals. Now we're putting in police. Wherever we go in, we get rid of crime.
The general says it will take time to win over Israeli Arab towns. But he has a new budget of about $30 million for extra policing in Arab areas, including 5 new police stations. How much time it takes may depend on how often this happens.
Well, Sam Kiley joining us now from Jerusalem. A fascinating piece, Sam, and an important piece as we look towards what is this fourth election in, I've forgotten, is it 2 years? Just over 2 years. I know you've been doing the election arithmetic. It means that traditional Israeli Jewish parties are reaching for votes wherever they can get them. What are the polls showing at this point as far as whether there is a clear winner? And who's jockeying for whom at this point?
Well, first of all, of course, especially with an Israeli election, but any election, of course, a health warning on polls, which have a margin of error of 3 to 4.5%, firstly. And secondly, they're notoriously unpredictable here in Israel. But if you look at the Haaretz poll of polls, for example, which is very much broadly, inevitably in line, since it's an average with recent polling, you're seeing Likud winning, say, 28 seats. That is the party of Benjamin Netanyahu. Now, the next party down, likely to win 18 or so, that is Yair Lapid's centre-leftist party. And then you've got two other right parties, Gideon Saar's New Hope and Yamina of Naftali Bennett. Naftali Bennett is to the right of Benjamin Netanyahu, but at the moment sees him as a sworn political enemy, and really at the moment he's playing his cards pretty close to his chest, but quite likely to throw his lot in with the anybody but Bibi type block. And that's what it's all about, Becky. It's not just who gains the most seats in the first round, effectively, of elections. It's the next round of horse trading, coalition horse trading, that really gets complex and complicated. And that's where the very fringe parties might come in terms of trying to build up enough of a block to be given the option to go forward into negotiations over coalition, which is why the Likud, led by Benjamin Netanyahu, have gone into a kind of coalition tickets, if you like, electoral tickets, with a very extreme religious Zionist group, which includes some homophobic elements, and why on the left there is increasing effort to not only court the Arab voters, but actually have Arabs on the ticket. Now, that might actually dilute the showing of the Arab joint list, which is showing about 9 seats in the 120-seat Knesset at the moment. But, of course, that will depend on how many people from each community go into the polls. In these elections, they can really turn on 20, 30, 40,000 votes. It's an extraordinarily close process, and as you point out, unlikely to produce a clear winner in the fourth election in 2 years, Becky.
Yeah, absolutely. We've been there for the last three, and don't we know it, these things are extremely difficult to call. Thank you, Sam.